Before the GM's meetings in Arizona, the Cubs made a splash with the hire of Craig Counsell as their manager, getting rid of David Ross after four seasons. That could be just the start of a very active offseason for the North Siders. Ryan Herrera of CHGO is joining us from Arizona at the GM meetings. Ryan, how are you doing? How are things out there?
Very good, Larry. Thanks for having me. Things are good out here. It's the start of the offseason, right? Like, starting to hear some of the rumor mill going, and it's the start of the exciting time in the baseball calendar, offseason baseball calendar.
Yeah, and certainly the hot stove is going strong. Ryan, I wanted to ask you, first of all, how much chatter is going on with the Cubs right now, not only because of their hire of Craig Counsell, but the fact it certainly seems like they're in on a number of players so far?
Well, as far as the rumor mill goes, like, the Cubs are in on plenty of players, right? Like, those are the rumors right now. Pick your guy. They're probably at least talking to the agents or have discussed the possibility, right? But yeah, I mean, you mentioned Craig Counsell. That was the talk of baseball coming into here on Monday specifically, but then obviously Tuesday and the GM meetings got flipped upside down a little bit when the Cubs surprisingly went out and hired Craig Counsell when they already had a sitting manager in David Ross. It was a surprise to all of us as well. But that definitely got, the ball rolling as far as, like, anything can happen at this point in the calendar.
How much of a strong, and this might seem like an obvious question, but how strong of a statement was that from the Cubs to say, and really back up their comments at the end of the season, that we're not accepting an 83-win season as a success? What message has that sent to Major League Baseball about what the Cubs' thinking is now as they look to 2024 and obviously with the new contract for Counsell the next few years ahead?
Well, Jed Hoyer, speaking to him the other day about Craig Counsell, he had said something along these lines towards the end of the season as well, is that he felt like the Cubs left wins on the table, whether that was at the end of the season, maybe throughout the season, that there were times where they just left wins on the table. And he felt like that this move needed to be made. Craig Counsell, we all know, is a very respected manager in baseball, arguably one of the best in baseball. And they just feel that Craig Counsell and some of those margins that may have lost the Cubs games here and there, maybe Craig Counsell could help stop them from losing those kinds of games. And you've seen his record in one run games or in close games. Craig Counsell is a very good manager, in-game manager, strategist. And the hope is that he could bring some of that success he's had with the Brewers and getting the most out of them and overachieving, so to speak, and that he could bring that to the Cubs over the next 5 years.
I guess in the end, we'll just take a little bit of a peek back. What's going to be remembered the most about the David Ross era? Because certainly the Cubs had a major core shift during his watch, yet were able to kind of rally back and at least be a factor by the end. What is Rossi's legacy as a manager in your mind?
In my mind, I think David Ross as a manager and as a first-time manager, right, 4 years into his managerial career, he proved to be a very good players coach. And you saw that over the summer when the Cubs were down 10 games below 500 on June 8th, and they were able to come back all the way to 12 games over 500 in September. David Ross is a players manager. Like, players like to play for him. They want to get up for him, and they want to win for him. As anything goes with managers, they're always going to take criticism for decisions they made or decisions they didn't make. And I know on the outside, there are fans that are definitely going to remember David Ross as the manager when the Cubs collapsed in September. For me, I think as a first-time manager, the best thing he was able to do was just to show that he's great at building relationships, getting players to continue to play for him throughout the season, regardless of how far down in the standings the Cubs are. I think that's a great first step for him in his managerial career. We'll see where that takes him, but to show that he can at least get that part, be a great clubhouse leader, keep the clubhouse together, keep players fighting, I think that's a good sign of a manager that has some learning to do for sure, but was able to get that at least done during his first 4 years as a manager.
Brian, you've obviously followed the club here. When you looked at free agency, what are some of the areas you think they really should target, at least based on what you've seen from the club the past year?
I think we are looking at, lefty power is definitely a area where they need to improve. And, having lost Cody Bellinger to free agency right now, that's an area where they need to improve even more on as compared to 2023. Whether that is obviously re-signing Cody Bellinger feels like a priority, whether that is going out on the trade market and finding someone. We saw, just power in general was a little harder to come by for the Cubs. But lefty power for sure is something that this team can stand to improve. And then the bullpen. The bullpen, we saw just a lot of finding roles for relievers for the Cubs this year. It took a little bit of time for Adbert Alzolay to lock down that closer role and Mark Leiter Jr. to step into his role, Julian Merriweather, Michael Fulmer, some of those guys. But then we saw by the end of the season, those guys had pitched a lot and started to break down. A couple went on the injured list. A couple were dealing with things in September that didn't allow them to pitch like they did over summer. And talking to Jed Hoyer, figuring out the right bullpen mix is definitely high on the Cubs' priority list. That doesn't mean they're going to go and spend all their money on bullpen arms and closers or what have you. But I do think they are going to take a really hard look at the bullpen market, whether that's free agents or trades, and see how they can build a better bullpen that can withstand a 162-game season, get them into the playoffs, and make some noise when they get there.
What kind of an impact would Shohei Ohtani have on the Cubs if they should be able to get him? Because obviously so many people have been saying that they're in on him. I guess what could you see him adding to this club, not only bringing an amazing star to the city, but also being able to add to that power you talked about and be able to add an elite player to that lineup?
Yeah, well, lefty power is, like I mentioned, is something that I believe the Cubs need to improve on. And I don't know if there's a better lefty slugger than Shohei Ohtani on the market right now or just in baseball in general. He's obviously an elite hitter, elite with the bat. And you also get the bonus of he's not going to pitch in 2024, but after that, he may be back to pitching and pitching at a high level. We'll obviously have to see where that comes, but with that Shohei Ohtani, you're at least getting an MVP caliber all-star slugger from the left side. Again, that the Cubs have been missing and are missing right now. You mentioned just the star power, obviously from the financials, like he's going to bring a lot of resources into that team just based on the star power that he is both here and in Japan. But to add to that lineup, to put Shohei Ohtani in the middle of that lineup could do wonders for the Cubs as they look to be an even more competitive ball club in 2024.
One player I think that's interesting to me that I maybe thought would actually take the next year on his contract was starter Marcus Stroman. Where do you figure his future could be with the Cubs? You view him as someone who's gone, or do you think the Cubs could be back in to try to sign him to a new deal here coming up for 2024?
Yeah, I don't. For me, yes, I was surprised to see him opt out. I do think now, kind of looking at the reasoning for why he's opting out, I believe he's looking to lock down a multi-year contract, which maybe the Cubs weren't willing to offer at the time. I'd lean more towards Marcus Stroman's time with the Cubs, at least for now, being done. I don't know that I see the Cubs going out and extending him or signing him to a multi-year contract. But that does leave, a hole in the rotation that needs to be filled. And the money that frees up allows the Cubs to be a little more flexible in what they want to do this offseason. Maybe they get later in the offseason and figure Marcus Stroman is the best pitcher that they could bring in, and they do a deal. I'll never say never, but I'd lean that that's probably less likely to happen than he leaves Chicago and goes elsewhere.
Ryan, let's go ahead finally and just take a look back at the 2023 season for the Cubs. Obviously, some players are leaving. Some players may or may not come back. But from a positivity standpoint, what were the things you noticed about the club that are staying around for 2024 that really can lend fans to believe that this is a team on the rise and can be competing for a World Series championship sooner than later?
Well, I think, and at the end of the year, there were some real glaring errors from the team or just defensive miscues. But I think for a team that was built on defense and run prevention, the Cubs really proved that they are in the top tier of baseball in that you have Dansby Swanson obviously winning a Gold Glove, Nico Horner obviously winning a Gold Glove, the best middle infield defensive duo in baseball. You have Ian Happ in left field and Seiya Suzuki in right field, two very capable outfielders. Pete Armstrong potentially coming up as soon as opening day in center field. Like, they have very good defenders all over the field. And if nothing else, we know, the old saying is defense wins championships. I don't know how true that is anymore, but to have a very stout defensive roster all around the field is a very good building block for this ball club.
Ryan Herrera will be covering the Cubs in Arizona this week and, of course, all the offseason as they approach what appears to be a very interesting time as the Cubs look to build themselves back to a World Series championship contender. Ryan, thank you so much for your time here on 9 Good Minutes.
Thanks, Larry. Thanks for having me.